Hi guys, it's midday on a Monday, and it's Monday the 3rd of April. I don't know what Nemo's doing, but he's running around. My plan for today, as my stepdad very kindly trimmed those bits of wood off for me yesterday when I was at Mum's, is to get the desk done. So I've got that shelf, where's my hand, there it is, to go up first. Because I do need to vacuum the floor and move the power cables, but I can't move the power cables yet because obviously I've got to relocate the one on the wall there, because this is uploading a video, but that's going to be done way before I've done the shelf, and I need to give the camera a bit of a charge. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to put this on charge on the computer for now. If I could find it, use my USB plug for a socket like that. I've got an adapter. Right, so the first plan. Get the shelf up, clear all this and vacuum the floor. It makes sense to do it before I do anything else. When I'm able to shut the PC down so I can unplug the power and move all these extension cords and whatnot out of the way. And get this corner piece, or end piece, up in that corner where it's meant to be. And that should give me enough room, sort of in this area-ish, if I move my chair, to build the other side piece I need, and the other end cabinet. So, I'm going to crack on, and we'll see you in a little while. Just over an hour later, there it is. Yeah, the telephone is beeping because I've got it unplugged, that's all. It's actually telling me the battery's going dead. Why is the battery going dead? Right. So I've got that speaker down. I'm going to move that. I'm going to take them screws out of the wall as well. This is a good little drill when it's got a good set of batteries in it. Got some electricery work to do, but I'm going to get my other thingy out of there, sound system, computer sound system, and look at it and see if I want to install that up this corner or not. And I really think I need to get that phone plugged in. It's driving me bananas now. And I'm actually thinking, as that black socket has got a long enough lead, I'm going to trail that around the back of this desk as well. Right. I'll just put you on the tripod. So I can actually trail this cable around and get some power back to the phone. Stop the thing bloody beeping. What are we caught on? Oh, so, you know what would be a good idea? We just unplug every bloody thing and start again. I'm gonna flip this stupid thing. Right. Oh. Can I tilt that forward enough? I don't know. Use a little extension lead on it, I will. Actually, you know what? I think an extension lead would be a better idea. As I've got one. Why couldn't they put a flame socket at the other end? Leads and cables everywhere. I have no idea why we call them leads over here. Is it because it leads you to something electrical? Shut shut up before I take the fucking batteries out of you. Doing my crusting now. Right. I knocked this computer case over earlier when that was switched on, and I thought that was going to crash because it did go over with a thump on the floor. And I actually thought, oh dear, that's jolted the hard drive and at least caused it to crash if I was lucky. No, it still worked. Right, so that's the plan. That's going to live up there. Can't go up there yet because I've got cables to feed around. But, yeah, I'll just move you. That's where that is going to live, with both monitors side by side on there, and probably with my subwoofer sound system up the far corner. There, so it'll be computer, monitor, sound system. The my internet hub, I'm going to stick up there on the shelf, so I can actually see what it's actually doing, if it ever goes down or anything. You never know. Right. There's so many cables and shit up here, I don't actually know where to start. I really don't. I think what I need to do is to stick... I've only got two screws in each of these planks at the top here, so I might just stick a few more in. Especially as I've got to pull the table out. I'll turn the screen around, I can actually see it on camera, can't I? There we go. I don't want to damage these speakers because you know, for an old pair of caravan speakers, RM Audio, RMS 620, they're pretty good speakers. Yeah, I've lost the grill to this one. I thought I'd kept hold of it because it fell off, but I haven't been able to find it. So, I got... actually got no idea where it is. I might still have the grill cover somewhere. I only put them on there, you know, just to prevent the speakers from getting damaged. But this is a good little pair of speakers. So I might, you know, reinstall these. Actually, you know, I might as well. Because I could stick them on the edge of the shelf up there. One up here, you know, somewhere. One up the other end. And then just put me subwoofer up the corner here. Yeah, why not? Yeah, if I have to shorten the cable, I will shorten the cable. That's what I'll do then. That'll also save drilling into the wall as well and putting them up there. Heck. All the dust on this, just from drilling and whatnot. Shed load of dust just come out the bottom of this case. All I did was drill six holes, eventually. Okay, I'm gonna need to get this friggin' Ethernet cable out of my fucking way. I'm gonna need to just open this cabinet here for the minute. After I've made a bit of room. Couple of tin towels down here. Because the power outlet I want to get to is right behind these Lego bottles. Where's that cardboard box? There we go. Oh, there's another bit. Parts to my space vehicle. Drag that out. Is that going to go under there? No, it isn't. Is it? It would if my little LED lights weren't under here. That would have just squeezed under there. Ow, I'm just squishing my finger. Right. Ow! You know what? That hurt when you kneel on a screw. Ow! That really does hurt. Right. If I've got the short and the power lead up there, then so be it. I will shorten the other power lead. But shortening it is actually going to be easier than lengthening it at the minute, so... You... Oh, you bastard. No, no. Ooh, I could do it this way. There we go. Oh, where are you? Okay. So I'm going to drag this end out enough. I need to get the cable down behind it. Like so. What the hell is that with my back? Who wants to plug? Just move you around. See, the panning motion on that tripod's brilliant. It just doesn't like to go up and down. Not without a jerking motion, anyway. Okay, so... Why is it computer cases get so filthy? Well, at least mine do anyway. Look at the state of it. I don't know if you can actually see it that well. Hang on a minute. In we go. You see all that friggin' crap on the front there? It's actually worse on the top and down the sides. Yeah. Right. I need a hole cutter. I've got to cut a hole. I'm going to cut it probably in the middle of this table. Yeah, I think I will shorten the lead on this black extension socket, but I can do that. Once I've got everything else done, there's no rush for that bit. But just to stop that proxy phone beeping at me. There we go. I'll plug it back in. I'll keep it quiet. I'll plug it back in. Right, that's one kettle lead. I think my yellow drill on the floor here is going to be the best one for what do you call it? Best one for drilling the hole underneath the cables. It's just going to be better putting a hole in the desk for the cables rather than trying to squeeze them down the back. Here's my lamp. I think I will need to invest in some of them sticky back clips that I used. Yeah. And I can actually put the cable, yeah, I'll do that. I think I've got a few quid in my bank still, so I'll, if I have, I'll see if I can get some later. Just want to get some stuff cleared off of this is what I want to do. Right, I'm going to smack myself in the snake with a plug. Right. I could hear a lorry or something moving outside. Probably thinking, why is that strange when I live in town? But no, it's not a lorry. It's the grounds maintenance team. They've come to cut the grass. They sort of do that outside once every couple of weeks or so. More than the local district council does with public land, because all that grass out front of my flat here is all owned by Victory. So their grounds maintenance team cut it. So if you hear some engine, well, you can hear it now. Yeah. That's their tractor machine thingy. Whatever they call it, ride-on mower, something like that. Talk some shit, don't I? Right. Unplug all of these from the router, which I want up here, and I can see what the indicator lights are doing. Believe it or not, I had once sorted all these cables out. It never lasts long. So there's the DVI cable for the monitor. I need that connected to the monitor. Fucking cables, get off. Oi. Why do cables have to be so friggin' annoying? What's this epoxy cable? Ooh, USB cable. Ah! I might want that for the printer. But I don't want that just yet because I don't plan to install the printer today. I'm having enough of a bitch job doing this. Right, that speaker's going to be a pain in the ass to move. From the router. Right, I've got to remember where my hole cutters are. In the toolbox in the bedroom, I think. What I'll do, I'm gonna switch you guys off and I'm gonna start, you know, drilling a hole in this desk and whacking in some extra screws, I think, and connect all the cables up, basically. So off I go. Well, I'm sitting down having a break, and believe it or not, this bloody battery's going flat again. I wonder why that is. I haven't used it. Anyway, I'll just come out of the way. The dual screens are working. I don't need that one on all the time, though. Got me hole cut when my cables are in place. It does look a bit like Spaghetti Junction in places, but I will be, when I can, it'll probably be next week now, I'll order those sticky back clips that I've ran out of, and I'll route all these cables I've got laying around nice and tidily. But for now, they'll just have to sort of hang and flap around in the breeze, as it were. But everything is in place. I just need to get a photo of this and get this out of the way. And the next job is to remove the shelf in the bottom here because it's slid back. But once I've done that, then I've just got to go and get some stuff from the other room and put it in place. I was going to put Lego up on that shelf, but I might just try and keep this corner as the office corner, so to speak. I do need to go through discs. What have I got? Nothing that I need. See, I don't know why I keep that. I've got that camera. Keep that one. Keep that one. What's this? Easy CD creator. Do I really need that? No. Photoshop Pro. Microsoft Office 2000. Those I will keep. XP Pro, don't need it, don't need that one either. There's a disc here with multiple things on it. Window washer. XP Home Boot, XP Pro Boot. Boot, rather. XP SP1, XP SP2. Empire Earth 2. Everest X-Print, Max Thumb, Print Screen, Sequoia, Screensaver XP. I'll have a look on that one. What have I got here? Oh, a friggin' empty case. This one I've actually had for years. It says Anime Disc Backup. Think. Got some anime pictures on there. I'm going to have you put that one. What's this one? I don't know, but that's a rewritable disc. What have we got? An R. Kelly CD here. Ooh, that flew well. what have we got here? Got some blank discs I forgot I had. Oh. Oh, that's an RW. Rewritable one. For the cat hair. And dust. These are all still sealed in the cellophane, so I will keep. I actually forgot that's what they were. I thought they were thingy discs. Right. And the other one, I think, is all my Windows discs. You know, I've got Windows 7, Windows 2000, Windows XP, Sound Blaster. I've got a few of those for some various devices. Another one for Microsoft Office 2000. Another Sound Blaster disc. Video what? Video cleaner. Restore films and save them to DVD. Oh, I don't fucking want that. We've got a lovely mess through there to clean up now. That's for a sound card. TP-Link Wi-Fi adapter. My brother's got that, so I will keep hold of that. Audio and video drivers for Compaq Armada E500. USB flash drive drivers for Windows 98 SE. Ah, that is the disc I made up for the Windows 98 Armada. That's just got drivers written on it. I haven't got a freaking clue what that's for. Well, it's got Windows 95 on the sticker, but I'm not sure that is. Bloody hell. Microsoft Office 97. There's another blue disc would just drive. Oh! I know what they are. Windows 98 Land Driver. Windows Millennium. Windows 98 SE. Windows 98 SE. 5-port USB PCI card driver, which I would need if I only stuck it on the doodah. Yeah. Alright, so I do need to keep those. Yeah, I need to clear the rest of this one off, and I don't know what to do with all these CDs though, because it's not often I use these, so I don't know. My phone's going to have to remain plugged into that one, because I've got a six-way under here and it's all the sockets are actually full. The only other option I've got is to put an eight-way down there, and I don't fancy doing that really. In fact, I'm going to turn that monitor off because I don't really need it. It's fun to play with though. I've just got to remember that my cursor, to get to that monitor, the cursor's got to go to the right of this one. I won't do it in both directions for some reason. It'll only do it going to the right. I don't know, maybe there's some... I've never done dual screening like this before, so... I don't know, there might be a setting I've got to tinker with, but... I'm happy. It's not going to go anywhere, not fast anyway. Bloody hell. That didn't sound too good. Actually, I've just realised my phone's not even connected to the phone socket. Oops. Be a bugger if people have been trying to ring me, wouldn't it? I'm going to put my phone possibly on that corner though. Or better yet, up on the subwoofer out of the way. I need to sort out one of my desk tidies. Sort it out so it's got all my pens and pencils and things in that I use the most, and just stuff everything else in the spare one and stick it to the back of one of these shelves. I might put some... I know what Lego I can stick up there. I know exactly what Lego is going to go up there, actually. Because I don't think... No, I don't think I'm going to need to put any computer stuff up there. I can stuff it all on these shelves. Right. I did put a post on Facebook saying I've got two of these computer discs going free. But unfortunately, for the time being, because I've got nowhere else to put this one, it's going to have to sit there. Which is a bit of a pain, because it's getting in the way. I might take the big shelf off out of the way. I think what I'm going to do now is finish clearing that off. The blank CDs I will stuff to the back on one of these, because I use them even less. It reminds me, I've got another spool on through there. In fact, I might just put the others I've got on that one spool. There's no point having three or four spools of blank discs that are only half full. I might as well just stick them all on one. I got it out of a charity shop a couple of weeks ago, and it's just been sitting in the bag down here ever since. Mostly because I forgot about it. See what I mean with this? Look, I might as well, I've got another one up there, which I think those are CDs. Or are those the DVDs? I can't remember. Ah, those are DVDs. But I do have this one for the CDs. I might actually get most of that. Oh, hang on a minute. We've got a mix of discs on there. Can you see the two different colours? What have I actually got? If I want that, really. So, we've got a bunch. Ah, we have a mix. These are DVDs. Yeah, right. What's under there? Asda CDRs. Is that what they all are? We've got some Philips at the bottom here as well. I just want to know if there are some Woolworths ones, some Maxell. I just want to go through and make sure there's no... bloody spindle broke off. There we go. I'm going to go through that one later and just make sure they're in any DVDRs on that. So, any DVD... Ooh, a blanky. A blanky thing there, right. Verbatim, however that's pronounced. Verbatim. These are DVDs. I didn't realise they were all mixed. I thought they were all CDRs. That one's got something burnt on it. That one hasn't. I'm just going to double check. That's clean. There's one there which has had something, Tesco one scratched a shite. Another couple of Tesco ones, again, scratched to high heaven. Could have something on those ones, I will double check. What's this? That one's got something on that as well. Okay. That's that one sorted. There's extra DVDs on there. Them Tesco ones aren't a lot of good. I'm just going to skip through these, just make sure they're all CDRs. Try to see some different ones further down. Stand that there. So now we've got Philips. Woolworths Worth It one here. We've got another one of those as well. And another one. What's with all these epoxy things, right? These in here goes. Oh, my battery's getting low. I won't finish doing this then, I'll go and put you on charge. I found something out. This camera doesn't like to charge from that USB plug thing I've got in the kitchen. I don't know why. I used the exact same USB cable that I use to charge it from the PC, and a little orange light comes on to indicate this is charging, but I charged it earlier, took it off, battery only had 9 minutes of life left, so I've just had it on charge for the computer. Charge for the computer? On charge via the computer. Get my teeth in. So yes, it is dark now, but it's actually nearly 10:30 at night. I got a bit sidetracked, because as you've probably already noticed, there's no computer desk here. It's gone. A friend of mine popped up. He wanted to borrow a bicycle, and so I let him borrow the piece of crap I was trying to sell. It was a piece of crap, really. But he might buy it off me anyway, so. But I asked him if he knew anyone that would, or wanted, one of my computer desks, and he looked at it and he said, "Yeah, I'll take it." So I dropped that off, bought an old cabinet of his back. I've got the wood out in the trailer. In fact, somewhere up here, in fact, there's a couple of the shelves from it, which I might be able to make use of, which is why I've kept them, because I can put them end to end, and I've got this lip edge there, so I could put an extra shelf in along here. That's my plan, just put them end to end, or I was going to put them under here when I get my bench top put in. Pardon me. Oof. That was a bit of heartburn, but yeah, everything is working fine. Dual screens working fine. I've got the other one off because I don't need it on. Otherwise, you know, it's just going to waste electric. I don't know how much a little monitor like that would actually use, but you know, it's not a big hefty thing. I don't really need a big hefty monitor that side. I'll unplug this because I've noticed drill chargers, they are warm, even though they're not actually doing anything. But with phone chargers, I've actually noticed, even though they're plugged in, they're stone cold. I know why. It's because these have a transformer in them. I think you'll find little phone chargers don't. They drop the voltage other ways. Because I left a loaf of bread on one of my battery chargers I've got in the kitchen here and left the charger plugged in. Because it's got a transformer, it was still, you know, technically working and generating heat. It actually toasted my loaf of bread. I'm lucky it didn't catch fire, actually. Yeah. This was also on the cabinet he gave me. Sort of a bodged lamp he'd put in it. Well, I say cabinet, it was just basically a wardrobe with no doors, that's all it was. Converted wardrobe into, like, well, what he had his computer on when he had it. So, I've still got a lot of various things I want to do. I've still got stuff to list on eBay. I still haven't done that yet. I think, now that I've got the main part of my desk done over here and that shelf up on the wall with both my Technic diggers on it, I could do one more up there, actually. I haven't got any large Technic models. I've got my drag car here. I've got my little skid steer thing. That's my case of spare bulbs I've got going in the bedroom, but that's full of shit at the minute. I can barely move in the bedroom. I've got a printer in there I've got to find a home for, which I might actually just sit on the floor over here somewhere. I was going to put it under there, but my feet are going to kick it. So I am actually thinking of sitting it probably down here, actually. I don't know if I've got a USB cable long enough. I'll think of something. Or I could just be clever, you know, and network it into the kitchen and stick it in the kitchen somewhere. Or even in here. Ooh, we've gone dark. Hang on. Ooh, it's rather cool in this room. It's been another gorgeous day, but it's cool in here. There's the printer. There, it's a reflector. I was just looking down there and I thought, I swear I just saw like a light light up or something. It's not, it's just a reflector when I was moving like this. I can see it's reflecting a bit of the ambient light in the room. So, yeah, I've got a lot of stuff here that will be going back in the lounge. I've taken a lot of the actual CDs through. I need to get the bench up before I can put these things in, because like I said, that's going to be the... Oh, excuse me. That was not intentional. I do want to get that bench up still to use as like a little work bench in there. Plus it'll just be like a little shelf as extra storage as well, as I need it. If I'm moving anything around, you know, that's light, I can just sit it on top of that. I may... In order to run the baton along the wall, I think I'm going to need to borrow my stepdad's stud finder. Because obviously it's going to support the weight of... or help support the weight of that shelf, bench, whatever you want to call it. So it's going to have to screw into the studs, and I could try tapping along and see if I can find them. But my stepdad's got an actual... stud finder. I've got a couple of short bits of wood I could stick up there, but I thought if I could get a piece which is near enough the same length as the bench I'm going to put in there, I know I'm going to hit several studs. I hope. Otherwise it'll fall off the wall. See, I don't know what the gapping is for studs. No, tapping it isn't going to work. It sounds the same all the way along. I will eventually shorten this cable. As you can see, I've got a lot of it down there. And I can't do anything with these dangling cables until I get those sticky clips. I'm going to order a box of 50. I do different... amounts. They do 10, 20 and 50, I think they might do 100 as well. Reason being, because I can do all this and any extras that I want, you know, probably route this cable properly as well. Route all the phone cable. That's going to be too thick for those cables. And I can go along my string of lights here and just tidy up that bit. I've got some larger loops there because I'm struggling to reach, actually. Not quite sure how I am going to reach. Where there's a will, there's a way. I could risk walking on these tables, but that's the size of the legs, so don't think that's a good idea. You know, I'm probably either close to or just over 200 pounds myself in weight. You know. I might only be 5'4", but I'm not exactly light. Look at this. Do you know I've had that since I was a kid? Whatever I've done, whatever exercise I've done, whatever diet I've had, just hasn't gone. And I am a believer of, you know, it's sometimes with some people that their size is their natural build. I've got a friend up the road. He can eat and eat and eat junk food. In fact, when he's at home, he lives on... pizzas and sandwiches from the shops and stuff like that. His diet probably isn't any better than mine, if not a little bit worse. And he's skinny. He is like the proverbial beanpole. You know, skinny as a rake, as the old saying goes. And then there's me. Mum fed me good meals. We had good roast dinners on every weekend. We had fruits and vegetables on a regular basis. I was always outside on my bike or whatever, playing around in the garden, you know. I wasn't the lazy kid that, well, games consoles weren't really a big thing then. Well, actually they were, but that was not really something. We didn't have one in the house until a Master System, and even then I wasn't really that interested in them, to be honest. My brother was the one that used to play on it more than I did. But, you know, what I'm saying is, you know, I was outside, I was in the garden, I was helping Dad. Out with friends, you know. But yet, I've still got this. It doesn't matter. It really doesn't matter what I've eaten or drank or whatever, it's just... it's not really gotten any bigger either. You know, I've just got a round belly that actually does look like I'm pregnant. Because I'm not out sideways either. It's literally like that. It's like a bump. I've had people joke and say, when's it due? And yes, I can take jokes like that. More so from friends. Which thankfully I think they're the only ones who have actually ever made that sort of crack, which is fine. But you know what? They reckon people with Asperger's syndrome and autism, you know, they reckon we don't have a sense of humour. We do, actually. Anyway, I'm going to shut this down. Tomorrow's task, I don't know if I'll put the camera on to film any of it, but tomorrow's task will be to bring some more stuff from the bedroom into here. If I don't do it a little later tonight, if I get bored. It is getting late though. But anyway, thanks a lot for watching. I hope you like this very poor sort of two-part video of a building this desk. It's not the best video on the planet, but anyway, thanks a lot for watching. If you did like the video, then please give me a like. If you didn't, give me a thumbs down. Perhaps tell me why you didn't, what I could have done better. See, that's one thing I like. If people are going to criticise me, give it, you know, constructive criticism. And I don't just say, oh, the video's crap. Tell me why, what could I have done better, you know. Be constructive in your criticism. Anyway, thanks for watching, and I will talk to you again in the next video. Bye.